What's up, XD Club? It's your future MCM, the AJ Styles of YouTubers under 300 subscribers. X3, and if you live under a rock, then you don't know what Talkin' Smack is. Talkin' Smack was the talk show that was after SmackDown Live every week, and it was actually really entertaining. But earlier, it has been announced that WWE, once again being the stupid idiots that they are, canceled weekly Talkin' Smack. Talkin' Smack was a platform that really elevated some of their up-and-coming stars, you know. It really showcased their promo skills. I mean, look, it gave us the best Miz promo he's ever cut in his career. And if you don't know what I'm talking about...
The reason I wrestle the way I wrestle is because I can do it day in and day out all the time for 10 plus years. I have never, never in my career ever have been injured. I don't get injured for 6 months to a year. I am here each and every week. But you sit there and call me a coward? Yeah. I'm the coward. Wait, let me tell you about a coward. Let me tell you about a guy who tells his WWE fans, the people that he loves, that he will be back. He promises them. I promise you, I will be back in 1 year's time to claim this title. But you didn't, Daniel, did you? But I'm the coward.
Okay,
I'm the one that doesn't love the fans.
If they would let me come back, I would come back.
Oh, you would?
Yeah.
You would. You love that WWE ring. You love wrestling. You love being right in that wrestling ring, and you love wrestling, right? Well, why don't you quit? Why don't you quit and go to the bingo halls with your indie fans then, huh?
No,
GM, have this. Thank you very much, Renee. This is a great show, but we're talking here. I need to talk to you real quick because the fact is, you're the one that calls me the coward, but you're the one that doesn't get in the WWE ring again. No, don't you walk away from me, Daniel. Don't you walk away. I'm the one that loves the fans. I'm the one that loves everyone and everything. You're the one that gets up and walks away every single time. You're the coward. I am not a coward. I am your Intercontinental Champion, and there's a reason I am the title. The reason making this the most relevant, prestigious title that WWE has, and I deserve the respect on SmackDown Live.
Yeah. Now, if you're wondering why they canceled Talkin' Smack in the first place, there's been reports that it's because they did not have high viewership. They're saying, really, no one watched Talkin' Smack. We're going to just take it off. Which is kind of BS. I call BS. If they're canceling shows due to viewership, I honestly think they should cut 205 Live. Now, I know I don't speak for the whole WWE universe, but honestly, when do you ever see anybody raving about 205 Live? No one really watches 205 Live. The only time I've ever watched 205 Live is when I was there at SmackDown Live in December. It's not interesting to me. It was a great idea in theory, but after seeing what they're doing with the Cruiserweight division, it's a waste. It's honestly a waste. My first guess is that they were cutting it due to budget cuts because, as you notice, there hasn't been pyro lately on Raw, SmackDown, and pay-per-views. That's because they're cutting that for budget cuts, which is kind of stupid because I love pyro. I mean, look, I complain about this every week. If they don't have SummerSlam pyro, I will be furious. But I honestly think they did cut Talkin' Smack because of budget cuts and viewership. But there's also been reports that Talkin' Smack is going to return only after SmackDown exclusive pay-per-views, which is okay. We'll still get Renee Young and, you know, some good moments, but it's kind of stupid that it's not a weekly thing because, honestly, it doesn't feel right that it's not a weekly thing. You know, we've been conditioned to expect Talkin' Smack. It's kind of like something for us to watch when we're not watching wrestling. It's like wrestling, but it's not wrestling, you know what I mean? And it gave us raw promos, it built storylines, and it elevated talent. So WWE really messed up with this one. Well, that's all the time I have for this video. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already, comment down below your thoughts on Talkin' Smack being canceled by WWE, and what other shows do you think should have gotten axed instead of Talkin' Smack. Also, follow me on Twitter at X34Ez. I tweet about wrestling a lot, I tweet about sports a lot, I tweet about everything, really. I'm a good follower, trust me. I'm a good follower. Also, share my videos with your friends, share with your family, share it everywhere. Help me grow, help the X3 Club. Help me grow, help the X3 Club grow. It will mean a lot if you show support on my videos, share them with your friends, share them with your family. Also, help me get to 250 subscribers because once I get to 250 subscribers, you know my girlfriend will come on my channel and put makeup all over my face. For video for your viewing pleasure. That's right, I will look like a pretty princess, but that's only when we hit 250 subscribers because that's a milestone I set for myself back when I had like almost 90 subscribers. So I want to get there, we're almost there. If you want to see me like a pretty princess, then hey, help me get some subscribers, all right? I'm X3 for the X3 Club. Tell you guys, to eat garlic bread and respect women.